Okay guys, this is the first episode to Shadowloo Bootcamp. This is a series that we're going to start with Street Fighter V. We're going to be going in the training mode, explaining the new game that just came out. They came out on Tuesday and everybody's pretty hyped with the game. I'm here with a friend of mine from the community also, Cristian Olivo, aka Angry Olivo. Seth player from Street Fighter 4. We're both Street Fighter 4 players. And, well, generally, we're just going to try to help the transition for all the players that came from Street Fighter 4. And, obviously, we're going to start off with a character that, obviously, I started in Street Fighter 4 is Bison. So we're going to go on training, but we're going to pick Bison versus Ryu, because Ryu is still a default character, which everybody knows from Street Fighter 2 till every other Street Fighter in the world. We're gonna go to training stage, obviously, too. As you can see, the roster has a few good characters. I'm gonna pick Bison. I already found my favorite color, which is the brown one. I don't have real colors.
It's just a standard color.
Please. Standard color. Okay. Well, with regards to the game, If you're familiar with Street Fighter 4, if you're not, well, there's a lot of differences in this game. One being that it has two mechanics, right? It has the critical art, as you can see on the lower side. You have the blue bars. That's the critical art, or super meter, as many people would call it. You can use EX moves. You can also do the super. Wow, my super's really bad. Which is that. But the most important part of this game is really the new mechanic, which is called the V system. The V system is the red bar that you see up there. It, as you can see, if you can see Ryu and Bison, the V trigger, the meter is different. Like Ryu's is a bit more shorter, Bison's a bit longer. It's a distinctive skill for each character. You can't move your mind. Let me fix that. We're both gonna activate the V trigger right now. Like I do it, right? It's distinctive for each character. Each character has different abilities when they do the V trigger. In Bison's case, he's faster, he has teleports that cross up, his scissor kick disappears. But the most important thing is that he can cancel his moves into other moves. But let's start with the basics, right? We got the two systems, right? We got the V trigger. There's also one thing that when you press both mediums, you got what we call the V skill. The V skill is a unique move that each character has. In Bison's case, it's a counter. If you only press it, he does that. But if you hold it, he'll automatically do a counter. And then we have the last part of the V system mechanic, which is the V reversal, which is when you're blocking, you press forward in three punches or three kicks. You can do it with three kicks also, right? Do it again.
It's specific to a character.
Okay.
Our beast can do it with three kicks.
See, and you do it through punches. Another thing, this will also do gray, will take away gray health. You can see Ryu's damage right there. Like, let's do it and let's hit you. Now get up. See? Look at the damage right there, because you get gray life. Now, what's important about this game is that, first of all, with Bison's case, you have to know your normals, right? You have your jab, you have your strong, fierce, short, forward, and roundhouse. It also changes depending on whether you're crouching. He has 6 crouching normals, he has 6 standing normals, and he has 6 jump normals. He has one specific normal, which is the down forward heavy punch. He does that move right there. And he also has a target combo, which is stand strong, which is this move right here, into down forward heavy. Now what's different about this game that's different from Street Fighter 4 is that there are no proximity normals. Like, close fierce is the same as far fierce. So the moves in general, it's a lot more summarized, I guess you could say. You can do a lot more, like right here, like back in Street Fighter 4, you could not cancel fierce into a scissor kick unless it was close. Now you can do far fierce into that. Now, after knowing your normals, you have to know your range, pretty much, combos that you can land after this. Like, Ryu has other combos as well, like you can do stand strong into stand strong or stand strong into crouching fierce. Now with Bison's case, you have to know your combos, right? Bison can do crouching. You can do three jabs. This is another thing that we can do in the game. In this game, you can chain cancel. But you can cancel chains. Back in Street Fighter 4, you could only cancel if it was linked. And in this game, you also have your own links. Bison has some good links. He has throw strong into crouching strong. And you can cancel that into scissor kick. Sorry about that. And after the scissor kick, or you can do his new move. This is the Psycho Inferno. It's a pretty good move, but it's unsafe on block. So with Bison's case, you also have his close roundhouse. This is a new move. He didn't have this move before. So what else can I say here? With regards to the EX meter, right? We were talking about the EX. In Bison's case, you can do... So yeah, you get a lot of decent damage. Ryu also has different EX moves, like you can do... It depletes one third of your meter. One EX. Yeah, that doesn't work. So if you're trying to learn Bison, what's most important with him? First of all, you have to know how to work his dash, work against fireballs, because now in this game it's easier to work against fireballs with Bison. You can even dash through the fireball, which is a lot. That's a big difference right now for him. You can do that. You also have this move, front of the fireball. You can do that. See, this game, fireballs, like, I don't feel them as strong as they used to be in Street Fighter 4 because there are a lot of ways around it. Bison never really had a good method against fireballs besides his EX scissor kick in Street Fighter 4. But the point with Bison in this game, he has good pressure, but his special moves are unsafe. This is unsafe. It's minus 4. No, you can land like a jab right after this. Or sure you can. You can do DP. Go DP. Low DP. Low DP comes out, I think, in 4 frames, right?
3.
3?
Meeting doesn't form.
Okay. Well, with the case with this game, you need to know, obviously we're talking about the way that you can work with the dashes now. With Bison, most of his pressure, his normal moves, these special moves are unsafe. But if you do his EX version, I need you to block and then reversal. Reversal DP right after this. Okay?
3 frames.
Exactly. That's 3 frames.
Yeah.
But if I do the EX one, see? Same goes for his EX scissor kick. That's actually plus 1. Do fear. That's his roundhouse scissor kick. Roundhouse scissor kick, surprisingly in this game, the stronger the hit, the safer it is. Because low scissor kick is minus 4. Medium scissor kick is minus 3. Roundhouse scissor kick is minus 2. And EX scissor kick is actually plus 1. So I want you to do a jab right after EX scissor kick. Crouching jab. See?
There we go.
You get a plus 1. Now, something very important in this game is offense is really important in this game, so you have to really know your frames. You have to really know what normals or what special moves leave you in a good advantage to keep attacking. Because in this game, if you get interrupted, like it's really easy to become the aggressor once the other person starts his game. So in this case, if I'm gonna do a block stream right now, I'm gonna do close roundhouse or roundhouse in general. And I'm gonna do stand strong, his target combo.
Yeah.
You're gonna do a crouching jab. You're gonna block that and then you're gonna do a crouching jab. Right there, I got a counter hit. And then if I get that... See, so you get a full combo right after, because after this down forward pierce, you're supposed to take that. You get a crouching strong. So, with frame data, if the move is plus, how can I explain frame data in a simple way?
It's about how faster your character moves before your opponent recovers from either hit stun or block stun.
Yeah, that's a good way to say it. In this case, after the close roundhouse, he's plus three. So this move comes out in eight, it's plus three on block. This move comes out in seven. So what you're gonna do is that, which means that the speed in which it comes out is seven frames. So it's more or less subtract and summarize, subtract. So you're gonna do, if I do this, it's plus three, you subtract the plus three to the startup of this move, which comes out in seven, which means that technically it would be coming like in four. So if I do this, Ryu's fastest normals are four frames, right?
Crouching jab is four frames, standing jab is three frames, but it doesn't have as much range.
It doesn't have range, exactly. So in this case, just because of that frame advantage, because if I were to just to do, if I were just gonna do medium and then medium, I'm block the first medium, I'm gonna do medium again. So yeah, I get interrupted. I'll get interrupted depending on the frames, because crouching, close standing strong is plus two. So if I do this, and I'm doing another one, see, that's in six. No, we have to do that. Crouching jab.
Okay.
See? And in some cases, he'll get the counter hit. So you have to know your frame data a bit just to make it better. So in this case, I'll just explain three frame traps, which are very important with Bison. Close roundhouse is plus three, so after this one, you can always do your close strong. That one's a good one right there. Or you can do stand short, and then you can do strong, because it's a frame advantage. The other move that's frame advantage is down forward fierce, that's plus one. Which means I can do a standing short, which comes out in four frames. His EX scissor kick is plus one as well. Okay, back to an important part, which we discussed at the beginning of the episode. We were talking about the mechanics which make this game different from the last version of Street Fighter, which was Street Fighter 4. This game has what we call the supers, which was from Street Fighter 2. It's called Critical Art in this game. And we also have the V system. Now the V system, as you can see on Bison's side, I have no meter at all. You can see on Ryu's side that he has full meter for both bars. Critical Art is divided into three separate meters, three separate bars. You can either use each bar for an EX. You can do an EX fireball right now. See, and you can, as you can see, it leaves one bar. Or you can do the super if you have full meter. Now, in the case of the V skill, the V system, I have Bison, right? So the way that you can build the meter is three different ways. Throw a fireball. If you take damage, as you can see, Bison's V meter is building up. Or you can use the V skill, in this case, for a fireball. It also builds for another fireball. Bison gets twice the meter because when he does the counter and he absorbs his fireball, you get a bit of V meter. And you also get another one when he does the counter. The other way to get it is if you do a crush counter. Now Bison has two moves, which are crush counter. No, he actually has three, which is his close roundhouse, his down forward fierce, and his crouching roundhouse. Now, in Bison's case, either of those three moves, when they hit you on counter hit, it does a specific stagger. But when you do that specific stagger, you also get meter. So I want you to do a DP,
yeah.
And I'm gonna block it, because in this game, when you block a DP, when I say DP, I mean Shoryuken, I mean any type of reversal. Different characters have different reversals. Once you block it and you punish it, if you use one of the moves that has the property of a crush counter, it's gonna get a counter hit automatically. Any move that you land after blocking a DP is a counter hit. So he's gonna do a DP and I'm gonna show you. See? And it says crush counter. Now, pay attention to the meter, to the V meter when I block it, when I hit him with the crush counter. Do it again. See, as you can see, I get like almost one full meter. Do it again. See, and now I have my full V trigger. Now, when I have the V trigger, I can either choose to activate the V trigger. You can either activate it by itself, or you can cancel a move. Most characters will extend their combos with the V trigger. So I'm gonna do this. See, and that's a combo right there where I canceled this move into V trigger, and then I did a standing fierce and I comboed into a scissor kick into another special move, because Bison's specific properties is that he can cancel special moves into other special moves as long as he has meter for EX and as long as his V trigger is active. Now, as you can see, the V trigger already ended. I'm back to zero. And he did a bit of pro fireballs again. You know what? We're gonna build this V trigger a lot faster. Do a combo on me. See? Now, I have 1 meter. I have 1 meter of V trigger. Right? The other important part to take away the offense from your opponents is the V reversal. Now I need him to do a jumping. See? Like I explained earlier, it gives you great health, great damage, right? That is a good move for you to get the offense to stop, for your opponent not to put too much offense. Another thing that's really important to know is that if you already activated V trigger, you cannot do a V reversal because the V trigger is already active and you're already depleting the meter. Because you need one full meter, one full bar, as you can see in Bison's side, to do the V reversal. I'm gonna attack on Olivo's side on the Ryu, and I'm gonna do a scissor kick and you're gonna V reversal. See? And as you can see, it does great damage. And since I'm taking great damage, I actually still build meter. I'm gonna do it again. See, and now I have it. Now, it's very important to know how to use the V system in different ways. I want you to do a Tatsu. Do a roundhouse Tatsu. Do it again.
I didn't know that.
You can actually, like, it actually... Because Bison doesn't only work against fireballs, it also works against normal attacks, physical attacks. So do forward fierce. Do it again. Apparently I can't do that part. Okay, just do a jumping roundhouse. Okay, now I have my full B trigger again. Now, with Bison's, I'm gonna activate B trigger and he's gonna do a block string. I'm gonna try to do a B reversal and you're gonna see that I can't do it. See, I'm depleting, see? But I can't do a B reversal. Because my meter is already depleting. Now, the property of Bison, don't block. See, that's the special ability. He can cancel each special move into another special move when he's in V-trigger. So I'm gonna put full meter, just so that you can see how that works in a match.
No, put V-timer on normal.
Exactly. See, as you can see, like, as long as I have EX meter, I can do more than one special move. So I'm gonna do this one right here. Oh, and you don't have to charge, that's the best part. Like these charge moves, you don't have to charge as long as you have the trigger active and when you're canceling. If you do the initial, see right now initially I do have to do a charge, right?
So you're canceling like special moves into itself and you don't need to charge.
Exactly, you don't need to charge at all. So I wanna do one of his basic combos right here, which is let me activate V trigger. Yeah, you can do that, or you can do, I hate his dash. His dash and V trigger crosses up, so it just gets me confused. Let me just activate it again. I have to do it slower. Okay,
we'll see in V trigger.
Anyways, that's some of the combos you can do. Like, let me just do one quick. I'm not gonna go in depth with Bison yet. This episode was more introductory, so you could more or less understand a bit of the mechanics, a bit of what are normals, what are special moves, what's the super, what's the new system with V-Trigger and the V system in general. But I'm gonna show at least one combo right now with Bison, with his V-Trigger. So yeah, you can see more or less the damage that I can do with just catching a person. I need you to do, I'm gonna do it straight off a punish, do a DP. Right? So I'm gonna activate V-Trigger right now after that. See, right there, I did a crush counter, roundhouse. After that, you can link the down forward fierce. I canceled down forward fierce into V-trigger. After the V-trigger, I did stand fierce into medium scissor kick. And since he has the property of canceling special moves, automatically after that, I did the EX Psycho Inferno, and I canceled that into EX scissor kick for a combo extender. That's only specific in V-trigger. He can't do that if he's
normal state.
No, like I can't cancel this flame into scissor kick if I'm not in V-trigger. That's a special ability that Bison has all on himself. I'm sorry for the, but basically I'm gonna post up a video with combo, because it's a lot harder to like go through each combo, each specific situation. So I'm gonna be making videos for characters each week. We're gonna do different characters. I am going to also post a fan page where people can actually like do the requests, or through our channel or on Twitter you can request the characters. Like right now, obviously we did Bison because Bison is the character with who I started in Street Fighter 4, and it's a character that I'm going to be using in Street Fighter 5 as well. But I also want to help, we also want to help you guys learn and help get the feel of the game. So with each week you guys get to request the characters you want us to get in touch with here in this game. We can also look for character specialists in the community to help us a bit more intel with regards to the characters. Olivo is an Ashe player. I know that Hollow is also a Lara player. I'm gonna also try to use this to help showcase the players in Puerto Rico, so you can get to know the scene, get to know the players, learn the characters, find out what esports in Puerto Rico is. Mostly it's trying to give you an introduction to the competitive side, but also how to build and level up your game. Right now, we gave a really short introduction. Next episode, I'm gonna go in depth with Bison. I'm gonna explain a lot of more complicated sections like the frame data, which we kind of skimmed through it, but I'm gonna have to do a little bit more elaborate to try to explain it better so that you guys can get a better feel and understand what the numbers mean. Okay, so that was episode one of the introduction to Street Fighter V. Introduction to the mechanics a bit, a little bit of Bison, but mostly the in-depth video for Bison will be the next week. I do recommend that you guys subscribe to our channel for the Shadowloo Bootcamp series. We will be doing a lot more content, a lot more character showcasing. As I said earlier, we're gonna be taking requests on our channel so that we can like go in depth with other characters that people would like to see. Right now, ending the episode, we're gonna try to do this more often. I'm gonna have different players from Puerto Rico for each episode to do a match showcasing their characters, in which case I'm gonna play a match with Olivo right now. You're gonna pick what, Nash?
Yeah, I'm gonna play Nash.
We're gonna play Nash versus Bison because I was showcasing Bison. This game is relatively new. We're both starting with the game. It's only been how many days?
Two
days since Street Fighter 5 came out. Everybody's pretty hyped. We're all still looking for our combos, looking how to learn the game. So we're gonna do a quick match. You gonna play on prep?
Yeah.
Okay. So quick 2 out of 3. Or we could just do 2 matches, and if it's 1-1, well then we'll sell it another episode. We can move on.
Okay, I like that.
I love that color.
I can't say much.
You know, somebody was asking me for to do a sprite a bit. 8-bit for Bison. It was like, what's your favorite color? I'm like, in Street Fighter V, I'm not sure yet. Of course we have it in Japanese, because they sound cooler.
Fight!
Able to combo that, but that was a super punish right there. Super punish.
Round two. Fight.
That short because it just comes out fast. So I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna throw it. It's a shame I can't chip. That's something that we didn't cover. You can't kill by chip in this game.
Come on. Fight!
That's a link right there. That's a post round, stand roundhouse into crouching spawn. Get into super, that's nice. That's not gonna kill, I think. Oh my
god. Damage!
There you go.
How did that miss?
Congratulations, you played yourself.
You played yourself?
Yeah. All round. Fight!
Yeah, let's do.
Well, that concludes the bonus match that we're gonna have in every episode. Next time, I think we're gonna probably have a Laura player by the name of Hollow, called Victor Cruz. He has an interesting Laura. I don't know if he has any secondaries. I guess we'll find out next week. But like I say, I really want to help showcase not only Puerto Rico, the scene, or how to level up your game, but I want you guys to actually get to know the players in the esports scene in Puerto Rico. Because there's a lot of players here that actually deserve a lot of credit because they actually do put in the work. They actually do travel to other events as well. Just a lot of people don't know about them as much. And hopefully this upcoming year, a lot of these people, you get to know them, not just in Puerto Rico, but outside in the States. And when you see us, just say hi. Puerto Rican crew is pretty cool. And anyways, I guess I'll see you in the next episode. Remember to subscribe. Follow us on Twitter. You can follow me at MonoPR. On Facebook, I'm also Mono. And you can make the request even by Twitter. Or just follow us on our channel in Shadowloo Bootcamp. Post comments. If you like the videos, let us know. Tell us what you like, what you didn't like. I would really appreciate the feedback because this is a series that we're starting right now with Street Fighter V. And hopefully there's a lot more to come and you guys keep enjoying this. Anyways, sign out. Say bye, Ali.
Goodbye, people.